That's right.
Yes. Yes. But anyway, it's a wonderful question that is asked here. But it's asked in the wrong way. This young lawyer comes to the Lord Jesus Christ in Luke chapter 10 and over in verse 25. In Luke chapter 10 and in verse 25, he says this, "And behold, a certain lawyer stood up and tempted him." You notice that he's not asking this thing in the right way, because immediately he tells us that he tempted the Lord Jesus Christ with this question, saying, "Master, what shall I do to inherit eternal life?" He said unto him, "What is written in the law? How readest thou?" Now, this is a lawyer, so Jesus knew that this man knew the law. So he says, "What's written in the law?" Verse 27, "And he answering said, Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy strength." He kind of throws that one in that wasn't there originally. "And with all thy mind, and thy neighbor as thyself." That's the answer. How do you inherit eternal life? He said you're to love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, with all thy strength, with all thy mind, and thy neighbor as thyself. And he said unto him, that is Jesus said, "Thou hast answered right. This do, and thou shalt live." But, every time you see something like that, you know something's coming. "But he, willing to justify himself," that is, he wants to look important, "said unto Jesus, And who is my neighbor?" And so then we have this parable that Jesus gives us of the Good Samaritan. Now, I'm not going to go into the Good Samaritan, and I'm not going to go into that last question right there, "Who is my neighbor?" Because he asked that to try to seem important in front of all of his friends. "And who is my neighbor?" To try to explain that one. Well, Jesus had the answer to him. Jesus told him all about the Good Samaritan, and that was the neighbor. So he answered that question. But the one that I want to look at tonight, is that first one that he tempted the Lord Jesus Christ with. When he asked the Lord Jesus, he says, "Master." Master simply means the rabbi. He said, "What shall I do to inherit eternal life?" That he's toying with the Lord Jesus Christ. He's playing with him. He's throwing some words at him. "What do I have to do to inherit eternal life?" He knew the scriptures. This man knew the scriptures, but he was trying to trip the Lord Jesus Christ up. He was trying to get him to say something that he might be able to throw out some of the scriptures to say, "Well, wait a minute, it says here in the scriptures this." And so when Jesus asked him, "Well, you know the scriptures, what do you have to do to inherit eternal life?" And he tells him, and Jesus says, "Yeah, you're right." So he could not trick the Lord, because the Lord said, "Yeah, you answered it correctly. Now, go do that." But the man wanted to take it a little further and ask another question. Who is my neighbor? But the thing that I noticed that really kind of jumped out at me was the use of the word inherit. Nowhere else do you find, except from this lawyer, does somebody ask, "What do you to inherit eternal life. Most of them have asked the Lord, how do I receive eternal life? How do I get eternal life? What must I do to be saved? They're direct questions. But this man uses the word inheritance. And that word inheritance is exactly what you think. In the Greek, I looked it up to see if there was any kind of trick words, but it wasn't. It's exactly what you think it means in the English. And that means something that you obtain or receive through inheritance. So that's the word that he's using. What do I have to do to inherit eternal life? Now, keep in mind, this is a lawyer that came from probably families that knew the law. His daddy probably knew the law. His mother probably knew the law. He came from probably a legalistic group. He's a Jew that truly knows the scriptures. He's a man that has enough scripture knowledge of the Old Testament that he's trying to trick the Lord Jesus Christ. So this man comes up and he uses the word inheritance. How am I going to inherit my eternal life? That word simply means, how am I going to get it passed down to me? How am I going to obtain it? You see, he understands inheritance. He understands what it means. It means something that he's going to obtain from people before him, from his mother, from his father, from an uncle, from an aunt, from my grandparents. I'm going to obtain something. All of us know about inheritance. You may have inherited something from somebody. I inherited a ring from my dad. That's what he left me, was a ring. And it was a ring that didn't fit. It was a ring that I couldn't wear. It was a ring that had things on it that didn't fit my personality or who I was. So I had the gold melted down into two little small rings, and I had all the diamonds, and it had lots of diamonds on it, but I took the diamonds from my dad that was in that ring, and I put them on those two little rings. And I gave one of those rings to one of my daughters and one of the rings to my other daughter. Now they have rings made out of the gold and the diamonds from their papa, and that's something that they have. It was an inheritance. I got it from him. He gave it to me. He wanted me to have it. I didn't know he wanted me to have it, but after his death, my mom gave it to me. So I had it. I've inherited a pocket watch. I've got a pocket watch that belonged to my great uncle. It was a 1915 Elgin that he bought when he went to work at the pulp mill out there at Brunswick Pulp and Paper. A 1915 Elgin. I was always fascinated when I was a little boy with that pocket watch. I still love pocket watches today. But I would watch him every day on the weekends when we would sit down at his house on the front porch, and that whistle out there at Hercules would blow at 12 noon. And you could hear it all through Brunswick, a big steam whistle. And he would get up out of his rocking chair, pull that pocket watch out, pop that stem out, and set it to 12 noon when that whistle was going off. And he'd pop that little stem in, give it a couple winds, and he would put it in his pocket. I used to love looking at that thing when I was a little boy. I used to love listening to it go tick, 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 tick. And he would pop the back off, and I could see all of those gears and things. And they fascinated me. And today I've got a number of antique pocket watches because of that inheritance. He left that to me. That's what an inheritance is. It's something that somebody leaves you. It's something that somebody gives you. Some people get great inheritances. Some get hardly anything. It's just what somebody has to leave you. I remember reading a few years ago of a man that picked up a hitchhiker in Las Vegas. And the hitchhiker, he dropped him off. The hitchhiker asked for his name, said, I'm going to send you something. And then he got something in the mail that was signed, and it said that in my will, I'm leaving you $1 million, and it was signed Howard Hughes. And he tried to collect on it after Howard Hughes was dead, and the estate went to court and had that thrown out, said it didn't come from him. But inheritance can be rough. Well, I tell you what, when some of your loved ones pass away, and you've got siblings or cousins or something, and if they've got something, you can see a fight like you've never seen before. Inheritance is something that can be good, or it can turn into a lot of trouble. This man uses that word. How am I going to inherit eternal life? How's it going to be passed down to me? And Jesus just stops him in his tracks, and he says, you tell me, what does the law say? And so he quotes the law, and Jesus said, yeah, if you can do that, if you can live that life right there, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy strength, and with all thy mind, and thy neighbor, as I said, if you can do that, you're going to be worthy of eternal life. And that's how you're going to inherit it. You're going to love God so much that you're going to do everything that God tells you to do. You're going to live that life just like that. Inheritance. This man wanted his salvation, and he didn't want to earn it. He didn't want to work for it. He wanted to inherit it. And this lawyer missed it altogether, because it's not inherited. You can't get it that way. It's not something that you can sit back and it being passed down to you because your mama and daddy loves you so much. It's not passed down to you because grandma loves you so much. Right. It's not passed down. It's not handed to you because you are somehow related to that person. No, there's something in that this man missed, and that's what I want to talk about tonight. Amen. And that is picking your inheritance and not getting it. That's what I'm going to talk about tonight. Picking your inheritance and not getting it. He wanted that inheritance, but he wasn't going to get it because of the fact that he knew the law, because of the fact that he was a lawyer, because that he was able to do one thing or the other. No, there was something that he was missing. And the thing that he was missing was that word tempted. And tempted him, say. He didn't ask the question sincerely. He asked the question insincerely. That's the point that I want you to see first of all. He asked Jesus in an insecure way. Insincere way, I'm sorry. He asked Jesus in an insincere way. You see, he didn't ask to truly know how to be saved. It says he tempted him, saying that. He was asking it just to try to trick Jesus. He didn't really want to know how to be saved. He wanted to somehow trip Jesus up. And so he asked it in a very insincere way. When you go to the Lord Jesus Christ seeking salvation, as we all know, because I'm talking to people that I know have been in church, and you've been raised in church, you know the Lord. I truly believe that you're saved, that and those of you that have been here and been in this church for a long time, you understand this. But the thing of it is that so many people don't understand, right, the fact that it's not something. It's not something that you do. You're not going to get it because you're a member of a church.
That's right.
You're not going to get it because mom and dad was a member of the church. You're not going to get it because you tithe or you give or you do some kind of work, because that's work salvation.
That's right.
There's a difference between grace and work. And when you come to the Lord Jesus Christ and you seek eternal life, you've got to ask that question, not how am I going to inherit it, but what must I do to be saved? And the answer is to believe Amen. On the Lord Jesus Christ. That's what God says. He tells us that we must believe to have faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. It's what Christ did for us on the cross of Calvary. It's not what mama and daddy did. It's not what granny did. It's not even what we did. It's what Jesus did. It's a gift that comes from the Lord Jesus Christ. But it's not an inheritance. It's something that's given to us because of what he did for us. And so many ask for salvation, but they ask it in the wrong way. Do you know there's people that have sought the Lord for salvation when they were in trouble? They wanted the Lord because they were in trouble. They were facing something. They were going through something. They were experiencing something. Some people have gone to the Lord and prayed simply because they got sick and they were worried that maybe they were going to die. So they start praying and asking God to be their Savior. But they really don't mean it. It's just that they're going through something that has frightened them. People sometimes go to God in sinful situations that they've gotten themselves in. And they go to God seeking salvation. I've known people that seem to come down the aisle and get saved. And fortunately not here, but I've been in churches before where people have come down the aisle to get saved over and over and over. Every time they get in trouble, they're coming down seeking for some type of salvation. That's not salvation. That's not, you don't inherit it. You don't come and get it every time you need God. But it's something that you realize that God is the Savior of this world, the Lord Jesus Christ, and you come to him truly seeking that salvation, Amen. That desire in your heart to give your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. That's what God wants out of us.
Amen.
God wants us to come to him truly wanting salvation, not every time we are in trouble, not every time that we need help, but the time that we truly want to give our life to Jesus Christ. He asked Jesus in a very insincere way. And that's not salvation. He missed it. He didn't get that inheritance that he was wanting. This lawyer did not receive his inheritance of salvation, second of all, because he didn't understand the answer. He didn't understand what Jesus Christ said. In verse 29, notice what he said. He said, "But he, willing to justify himself, said unto Jesus, And who is my neighbor?" He's now coming to the Lord Jesus Christ and starting to ask questions about things that didn't have anything to do with what Jesus told him in the first place. He's the one that came to the Lord Jesus Christ. He's the one that asked questions. And the Lord told him what he needed to do. But now he's starting to pick it apart. Well, the Lord told him, you're to love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and all thy soul and all thy mind and thy neighbor as thyself. And now he's wanting to start to pick it apart. Well, explain to me this. Well, explain to me that. Well, no, do what he said. Do what the Lord said. But he wanted to begin to kind of tear it apart. He didn't understand the answer in the first place. He's going beyond what the Lord said. The Lord told him what he needed to do. And the Lord said, notice in verse 28, he said unto him, thou hast answered right. And then what did he tell him? This do, and thou shalt be saved. Do it. And so that was that's where Jesus ended it right there. Here's the period. Go do what we just said. Love the Lord thy God with all thy heart. Love the Lord thy God with all thy mind, with all thy strength, with all thy soul. Love the Lord. And if you love God that much, then you don't have to worry about anything else. If you love God so much, you're going to do what the scriptures say. You know, if this man truly loved God as he said he did, he would know who the Lord Jesus Christ was in the first place. I mean, he would know who Jesus was. If he loved God with all his heart, God would have made it completely clear, here's the Savior of the world.
Amen.
Here's the Messiah. Here's the Son. Here he is. If you love God so much, here's the very creator of the universe standing right here in front of you. He would have known that if he truly loved God the way he said he loved God. But he didn't, because he starts asking questions. He begins to start tearing this whole thing apart. Listen, you've got to accept it by faith. You've got to believe by faith. It is the Lord Jesus Christ. He is the very Son of God. He is the Savior of the world. He was the Messiah to the Jews. He is the one that died on the cross for our sins. He sacrificed that you and I could have eternal life. He said that he was the only way. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. It's just clear. It's what we're to go by. It's what we're to live by. It's what we're to accept. We accept it by faith because Amen. He said it.
That's right.
And we don't question. And yet this man, this is the reason why he didn't inherit that eternal life, because he begins to question everything that Jesus said. That shows me right away that he's full of doubt and he doesn't understand it. There's something else, the reason this lawyer missed this inheritance. And that was because he could not follow the directions of Jesus. You know, when we get saved, Jesus gives us directions on how to live our life. And that's what he expects us to do. And he says so in verse 28. He says, and he said unto him, thou hast answered right. That is, he said that you're to love God. And he says, yep, you've answered it right. And then he gave him the instructions. This do. Do that, and thou shalt live. Just do it. Do what you just told me that you are supposed to do. And you're going to have that eternal life. He could not follow the directions. This man was a sinner. He didn't truly love the Lord. He was questioning God. He's standing right in front of the Lord Jesus Christ. And what does the scripture say? The scriptures are saying he tempted him with these questions. That is that he's trying to trick him. He's trying to get him to answer in some way that he could try to find mistakes with him. He said, well, what does the scripture say? How should I do this? What do you say? He's trying to get Jesus to answer something that he could say, whoa, wait a minute, the scriptures say this and you said that. He's simply trying to play Jesus and trick him, and Jesus would not answer him at all. He just said, yeah, what does the scripture say? He let him answer. And then when he said it, Jesus said, you're right, go do it. And the man would not do it. He could not do it. And so here we have a lawyer that could not follow the directions. The directions are simple to us also. Go do these things. That's it. Love the Lord thy God with all thy heart. Go do it. Love the Lord thy God with all thy mind. Jesus says, go do it. Love the Lord thy God with all thy soul. He says, go do it. Do we do it? That's it. He says, go do this and you will live. you're going to have eternal life if you can live it. But can we live it? Can we love God with all of our heart, with all of our soul, with all of our mind? I hope we can. I hope we can have that much love in which we would not step out of bounds at all. Because what was the directions? The directions were simple. There were two words: go do. That's it. It just go do what you just said, and you'll have eternal life.
That's right.
But this man, he wanted to mock Christ. He wanted to trick him. He wanted to try to bring up something against him. And that's not salvation. This man missed his inheritance. This man missed the whole thing. He wanted to inherit eternal life, but he wanted also to be important. This, he said, to tempt him.
That's right.
Yeah, he was wanting everybody to look at him. You know what? We need to get our attention off of us.
Amen.
And on the Lord Jesus
Amen.
Christ. And that's the eternal life. So let us give our full attention to Christ. That's what we need to do. Follow him with all of our heart. Love the Lord thy God with all of thy heart, with all of thy soul.